Okay then, Joe, we're back in the electrical workshop and we're going to look today at some popular early misconceptions of our learners. So they're going to be with us for the first 2 or 3 weeks. Mm-hmm. And we start getting things slightly confused from the start. It doesn't help us moving forward.
Yep.
And we're going to be looking predominantly in this video at the Batten lamp holder.
Sure.
Talk me through some of those little misconceptions, Joe.
So perhaps one of the first things that we might get a little bit confused about when we start looking at Batten lamp holders is the fact that we've got two white wires here.
Okay.
Now that might be a little bit unusual to a learner coming into this because so far we've been speaking about brown and blue conductors.
We've been talking
about line and neutral. At no point have we spoken about white conductors. So the first thing to clear up really is why are there two white conductors in here, Gaz?
It goes back to a video that we shot where we talked about lamps, didn't it? Where we talked about different varieties of lamps.
Yep.
So we've got a lamp here, and again, as it's a new video, what is it not, Joe?
It's definitely not a bulb, it's a lamp.
It's an electric lamp, and we'll get to that in the classroom or in the video that we did on lamps. And we've got the bayonet cap lamp holder on the end.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and we also look in that video at Edison screw, but we're going to concentrate on the bayonet cap one here. Yep. And we talked, didn't we, in a previous video presentation that the two contacts on the top, which one's line and which one's neutral, Joe?
We have no idea and it doesn't matter.
Okay.
And when you think about that, when you're in your own home and you're changing an electric lamp into your light fitting, you don't think, I must put it in the right way round. You just put it in, don't you? And it works either way. But that's because this kind of lamp has no polarity. In other words, it doesn't matter which one of those two terminals you connect up to the line and which one you connect up to the neutral.
Okay, so with that in mind then, so it doesn't matter which one's line and neutral, and we're going to say in other videos, and this one as well, we'll just drop it in again, it has no polarity.
Exactly.
So when we drop over to your Batten lamp holder,
that
one here, I've got part of it, you've got the completed one there.
Yep.
Is that why they're both white then?
Yes, that is basically the reason. Now, what we're not saying here is it doesn't matter where your line and neutral conductors go into the base, but once these two wires have left the base, picking up the line and the neutral, it doesn't matter where they go into a Batten lamp holder type lamp holder. So that's what we're looking at there. So that's the reason that we don't have a brown and a blue conductor inside our Batten lamp holder.
In this make?
Yes.
In this make. So we grab a different make.
Absolutely.
So again, we come to this one.
Yep.
Okay, we got a...
And
it must matter now.
So I believe we've still got a Batten lamp holder. So we've still got a bayonet cap lamp there. So it doesn't matter about the polarity of the lamp. However, this manufacturer has chosen to go with brown and blue.
Okay. So again, when our learners get them out, they're thinking, oh, right, I've got a blue one, I've got a brown one.
Yep.
Again, for my learners and learners out there perhaps that are watching, still check that the person before you hasn't taken these out at some point and actually swapped them around. So even though the lamp holder has no polarity, we'd expect the blue conductor to be connected in the block of three labelled neutral, and then the brown conductor in the block of two labelled with an L. And we always say at this college that is actually switching line, not just an L. Centre terminal, what's that called, Joe?
That's generally called the loop terminal. I always think of it as the permanent line connection.
Yeah, brilliant.
So that's where your permanent line conductors go. And that middle terminal will always be live as long as the circuit is on. That will always be live, which is, again, another good reason why we must perform safe isolation, which we've done a little video on, to make sure you can't just switch it off at the lamp because that only turns off the L terminal and not the loop terminal. So there's still live parts in there.
So while we're doing popular misconceptions early on for our learners, that's a block of three. Let's use that one as the example of which our permanent line conductor can come in and go out. And then there's usually one down to a switch as well. So it could be populated with three conductors.
Yep.
All what colour?
Or they'll all be brown.
Okay, and our learners will come to us and they'll look at the drawing they've got and they'll see how they go in particularly into a hole.
Yeah, yeah.
So there's three holes, so as we look here, so there's a brass block of three with three holes, Joe.
Yep.
And it's vitally important, isn't it, Joe, that they get them in the right order?
Absolutely not. That's one of the common questions that we get asked during lessons is, I've got these three terminals in the middle block, effectively. Which one do I need to put my line conductors into? Well, if you're putting it in there, it's going to be permanently lined whichever hole you connect it into. So normally the right answer is whatever looks the neatest.
Good.
That's the way forward.
And we're laying and dressing cables out. We'll just pick up another thing or two as we go through, that these blocks of three or blocks of two are separated by insulate us from each other, so yep. they can't touch each other. And the nominal value of voltage for these accessories is 250. Mm-hmm. And we'll talk in the classroom about how the voltage can rise and fall from the yep. nominal value of 230. So we'll hold yep. that one back for the classroom. We like to leave little bits out of our video, don't we?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So we can just blend it yep. in as we go along.
So our learners get something live.
yeah, the live show. But when we're looking at the flexible cord coming to our ceiling rose and pendant, as it's a flexible cord, Joe, yep. they're always going to be blue, yep. they're always going to be brown. It's yep. only in the Batten lamp holders,
yep.
do you agree, where we can have a combination of
yep.
either the white
yep.
or the identified
conductor. Sometimes get the white, yep. yeah, absolutely. While we're talking about pendants,
yep.
Another sort of just little point there. Again, our learners often with the Batten lamp holder go to lots of trouble of wiring these flexible conductors here going out to the lamp holder itself through the cable retention, through the cord
yep.
grip,
yep.
and making sure that that's in there. Now, when you're installing a pendant type light fitting, that is really important.
Absolutely.
Because you don't want the connections to be taking the weight of the light fitting.
No, you don't.
You want the actual plastic part to be taking the weight of that. Yep.
Yeah.
But in a Batten lamp holder,
okay.
we don't need to use those cord grips, we don't need to use that cable strain relief, because actually the whole light fitting just screws onto the base.
Okay.
Like so.
So there's no stress on those two conductors yeah. behind it.
Yeah, absolutely.
Wherein obviously the ceiling rose and pendant, there's a chance that we can have something heavy pulling exactly. against those, so we use the, yeah. the cord grips available in the actual rose itself.
Yeah.
So I think there, Joe, yep. we've covered quite quickly some of those popular misconceptions.
Yep.
Yeah, that we could have two white conductors. Mm-hmm. We know they can be white because there is no polarity on a bayonet cap lamp.
Yep.
We know that our terminals, does it matter which of the three we choose, say, for a line conductor?
No, so just to clarify that, we've got three blocks of terminals, haven't
yes.
we? We've got the one marked L,
yep.
the one marked loop, and
yep.
the one marked N or neutral.
We have.
And within those three blocks, two of the blocks have three holes in them.
Yep.
And those three holes, it doesn't make a difference which line conductor goes where in the center block, and it doesn't really matter which of the two holes the neutral conductors go into. We normally keep the flexes on the very outer
yep.
terminals,
okay.
don't we? That's really good practice. So yep. we would suggest that that's the way forward. But apart from that, it doesn't actually matter which one of the holes it goes into, as long as it's the right conductor.
They're made of brass.
Yes.
Not copper.
Not
They're
copper.
Made of brass, okay? A non-dissimilar metal to copper. So
yep.
when we terminate the two, there's no electrolytic corrosion between the two. So
yep.
we'll talk about that as well in the classroom. So Joe, I think as a little kickoff for those first 4 or 5 weeks that our learners are underway
yep.
with, I think we've covered some of those popular misconceptions
yep.
about the Batten lamp holder. Shall we end it?
I think we will.
We hope this video has been some help.